The Honourable First Minister.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Elders, survivors, guests, and members of this chamber, I am humbled today to speak about a tragedy widely known as the Sixties Scoop. This wide-scale national apprehension of Indigenous children by child welfare agencies removed thousands of children from their families and communities. Je me présente avec humilité aujourd'hui pour parler de la tragédie connue sous le nom Sixties Scoop. Cette appréhension à échelle nationale d'enfants autochtones par notre système social a enlevé des milliers d'enfants de leur famille et de leur communauté. These children were placed in non-Aboriginal homes across Canada, the United States, and even overseas. While some adoptive families took steps to provide culturally appropriate supports to adopted children, the 60s Scoop is recognized as a practice of a forced assimilation, and one that extended well beyond the 1960s. There is not an Indigenous person in this country who has not been affected by the residential schools legacy, and the number of Indigenous people affected by the 60s Scoop is also very large. Across Canada, the number of adoptees is estimated to exceed 20,000 First Nation, Métis, and Inuit children. By separating these children from their families, they were stripped of their culture, language, and traditions. Judge Edwin Kimmelman, and the author of the 1985 report, No Quiet Place, on the child welfare system and how it affected Aboriginal people, described the 60s Scoop as cultural genocide, the very term that Chief Justice Beverly McLaughlin and Commissioner Murray Sinclair used to describe the residential school system. It is important that we acknowledge and appreciate the meaning of that description. The reality is that, like the residential schools, the effects of the 60s Scoop remain with us today. The human impact on families and communities are profound and cannot be easily reconciled. The 60s Scoop must now be recognized for the harm it caused and continues to cause. Many of the adoptees experienced profound shocks as they lost their heritage, language, families, and their identity. Many of those who later returned to their communities as adults found it equally challenging to rebuild their relationships and connect with their culture. Today, as Premier, I would like to apologize on behalf of the Province of Manitoba for the 60s Scoop, the practice of removing First Nation, Métis, and Inuit children from their families and placing them for adoption in non-Indigenous homes, sometimes far from their home community, and for the losses of culture and identity to the children and their families and communities. Comme Premier Ministre, je prends cette occasion pour présenter une excuse officielle de la part de la province du Manitoba pour le 60 Scoop, l'enlèvement des enfants des Premières Nations, Métis et Inuit, de leur famille et leur placement dans des familles adoptives non autochtones, parfois très loin de chez eux, pour la perte de culture et d'identité, celle des enfants et de leur famille et communauté. It was a practice that has left intergenerational scars and cultural loss. With these words of apology and regret, I hope that all Canadians will join me in recognizing this historic injustice. I hope they will join me in acknowledging the pain and suffering of the thousands of children who were taken from their homes. By recognizing these difficult truths, I hope that we can join together down a new path of reconciliation, healing, and cooperation. There is a long road ahead of us. It takes time to heal great pain. But I stand here on behalf of the Manitoba government, committing to doing our part in the reconciliation process. Last year, the province, led by the Deputy Premier and Minister of Aboriginal and Northern Affairs, held a two-day roundtable with 60 Scoop survivors to discuss their stories and put forward an action plan. This roundtable was the first time in Canada that such a gathering was hosted by a government. Days later, on behalf of the province, Colleen Rajot, herself a 60 Scoop survivor, and Chief Francine Meaches of Swan Lake First Nation, presented to the Truth and Reconciliation Commission final national event on the 60s Scoop. Then in April of this year, on behalf of the provincial government, Colleen Rajot and Leah Gazan spoke about the impact of the 60s Scoop on First Nations, Inuit, and Métis children at the United Nations Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues. These actions brought much needed attention to this important issue. but still much more needs to be done to assist Sixties Scoop survivors. This week, the Manitoba government opened the adoption records to ensure they are more accessible to survivors at the Sixties Scoop, along with other adoptees. The records help adoptees and birth parents connect with each other, giving access to birth certificates, adoption documents, and other information that had previously been kept confidential. We believe that all children have the right to know who their birth family is, particularly those who are part of the 60s Scoop generation. And for those individuals seeking information, important to identifying First Nation, Métis, or Inuit heritage. There has been a great deal of interest from adoptees along with birth parents. Acknowledging the 60 Scoop legacy, as well as opening adoption records, are very important steps forward on the road to reconciliation. However, we know there will be many challenges for those who discover their family origins, and we want to assist them. Today, governments across the country are reviewing the calls to action and summary report of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission of Canada. Manitoba has started on many of the recommendations in the areas of education, family services, justice, and missing and murdered Indigenous women and children. We are using the report as a guidepost for further action. Under the leadership of Manitoba's Deputy Premier and Minister of Aboriginal and Northern Affairs, the Canadian ministers responsible for Aboriginal affairs and national Aboriginal leaders have advocated for the 60s Scoop and missing and murdered Indigenous women and children to be addressed at a national level. As Justice Sinclair has said, an apology without a change in behavior is meaningless, and all levels of government need to admit their responsibility. We have made progress on missing and murdered Indigenous women and children. All Canadian provinces now support a national inquiry on this issue and have committed to holding another national roundtable within 2 years. We now want to see national recognition brought to the 60s Scoop, and today we commit to raising this important issue at the next national roundtable. We also know that education about the 60s Scoop and its impact on First Nation, Métis, and Inuit children needs to be part of education curriculums across the country. In Manitoba, we will be doing exactly that. In closing, I would like to once again apologize on behalf of the province to the innocent children and their families for this practice that, in the words of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, removed thousands of Aboriginal children from their families and communities and placed them in non-Aboriginal homes without taking steps to preserve their culture and their identity. We look forward to further leadership on residential schools and the 60s Scoop from the Truth and Reconciliation Commission this fall in their final report. Ekosane, Migwich, Masichu, Mutna, Wopida, Hai Hai, Merci, and thank you, Mr. Speaker.